We're talking about cancer and its worrying ascent around the world. Cancer is on the rise, largely because globally, populations are aging and cancer risk factors are spreading, especially in developing nations such as Nigeria. Smoking, high-calorie diets, and obesity are increasing rapidly in low- and middle-income countries. Breast cancer is the most frequently diagnosed and the leading cause of cancer deaths amongst females, overtaking cervical cancer and now accounting for 23% of the total cancer cases and 14% of cancer deaths. Lung cancer is the leading cancer in males, comprising 17% of the total new cancer cases and 23% of the total cancer deaths. People often suffer because of inadequate medical care and poor lifestyle choices. Cancer is a disease of the mind, body, and spirit. A positive spirit with less anger, stress, and bitterness puts less strain on the body. Relax and enjoy life. Keep illness at bay. Let's look at this video and we'll be right back. In the time of our
life. What's behind the projected rise in cancer cases? Joining me now is Dr. Otis Brawley. He's the Chief Medical Officer and Executive Vice President of the American Cancer Society. Welcome, Dr. Brawley. So tell me, why are these cancer cases going to be spiking so much?
Well, there are two reasons. One is a good one, and that is the population is getting better and getting healthier, and we're seeing more people live into their 60s and 70s in the developing world. The other reason is a bad one. A lot of the bad habits that cause us to have very high rates of cancer in the United States and Western Europe are now being exported to developing countries. I'm talking about tobacco smoking. I'm talking about diets that are high in calories as well as obesity.
So, Dr. Brawley, when it comes to the tobacco smoking and the diet, is that what the report is talking about when it says half of all cancer cases could actually be avoided using what we already know?
Yes, that's absolutely correct. In the United States, for example, 33% of all cancers are related to tobacco. About 28-29% are actually related to obesity, high caloric intake, and lack of physical activity. And these are bad habits that are actually starting to be spread around the world. To Africa, South America, and Asia.
So what more can be done on prevention, both from a medical community standpoint and from, you know, just an ordinary person? What could I do?
Well, many people don't realize that the obesity epidemic has been linked to 12 different cancers. So the first thing we'd recommend is people actually try to maintain a normal body weight, try to get some physical activity every week. And then, of course, I cannot leave without saying do not smoke. Those are the major things that people can do. Beyond that, we need to talk about vaccination. HPV vaccination is going to prevent a lot of cervical cancer. Hepatitis B vaccine will prevent a lot of hepatomas or liver cancers, which are, of course, the second leading cause of death worldwide. In the time of our
lives. We really must begin to take note. Cancer, serious business. So, Dr. Olufemi Olaleye is here with us today. Dr. Olaleye is the CEO of Optimal Healthcare Foundation, a social enterprise focused on strengthening the delivery of primary healthcare in Nigeria by building a network of optimal medical centers to deliver low-cost primary and maternity care. Dr. Femi also founded and runs Wish for Africa Foundation, a UK-based charity dedicated to improving maternal and child healthcare in underdeveloped communities in Africa. Welcome.
Thank you.
Thank you for being here with us.
Thanks for having me.
So we have a few questions we're going to ask, as always, on Walk the Talk, to hopefully help shed some light on this, you know, very, very important and pressing issue, which is, you know, basically how our lifestyles, you know, are, you know, creating all sorts of new illnesses which are affecting us as women, obviously.
First of all, every human being is at risk, not just women. The woman out there, every human being. Man, woman, child, old, young, are afflicted by one form of cancer or the other. One in three is actually the statistics. So if there are 30 people in a room, 10 will possibly die of one form of cancer or the other.
Wow.
Wow. Cancer of the brain, cancer of the eye, cancer of the tongue, cancer of the lungs, cancer of the breast, cancer of the prostate, cancer of the penis, cancer of the leg, cancer of the bone, cancer of the uterus. Over 55 types of cancers out there. And we know now that we can certainly prevent some of these cancers by some of the lifestyle changes you mentioned earlier. A lot of people don't know what they're supposed to know to sort of safeguard and protect themselves against these cancers. Mm. But more specifically, there are also things about what you put in your mouth, because we are what you eat.
Yes, very true.
Yeah.
We know certainly that if you're obese and you don't do a lot of exercise, you have a lot of spare fat tissue in your body, your body will try and convert that to some things. And in that process, you could actually have some cells losing the memory to die. But however, not all obese people end up with cancer. So that means there must be other cofactors. And one of the other ones we now know is obviously smoking. If a person is smoking, the carbon inside the smoker's inhaled smoke has a way of affecting the ability of the cells to either die or multiply rapidly.
Of late, there just seems to be an extraordinary level of cancer rising. I know they say this statistically. I believe I read that in the next 20 years, we were looking at an epidemic on the cancer cases around the world. I think it was something like about 57% in 20 years or something.
25, okay.
So I'm just wondering, what has changed here? Because we didn't used to hear about so many people dying of cancer.
Two things.
Young people.
And young people,
two reasons, two reasons for that. One, kudos to people like you. People are talking about it more. The second reason why we seem to be seeing an increase is mainly because we're not doing enough screening. We've been talking about women all along.
But men,
pardon me, prostate cancer is the number one killer of men over 40 in Nigeria right now. And it's a disease we can prevent through just a simple blood test called PSA, prostate-specific antigen. So women, please help us raise awareness. You know, tell your men, tell your daddies, tell your uncles to go do their PSA. One of the things we noticed in cancer work is that the incidence of breast cancer is the number one in the world. A global cancer study looked at all sort of cancers that's afflicting human beings, and breast cancer always top. Women should actually engage in getting their breast checked themselves. So the idea is you feel comfortable with the softness of your breast and you move to the side, which is 3 o'clock, underneath the nipple, which is 6, and end up at 9 o'clock, and then you go towards the armpit, which is why you should actually raise up your hand so that you can do that. And then you swap hands, opposite side, and do the same thing, and then end up with the armpit. If you feel a lump in your breast as a woman, don't panic. Do the classic normal process, and reject it, because we're all sort of prayerful like that, and then do that, and then next thing is come and get it checked out, because most of the time it may not actually be a cancer. Majority of women, thankfully, by doing that, they can pick up lumps in their breast long before it becomes a symptom. And by the time it gives a woman a symptom, which is pain, heaviness in the breast, it's almost too late. So we advise women to do this every month. Themselves. And I've got something, a few other things that can help women. This lovely young doctor, I won't mention his name, came up with this thing called Breast Aware, Breast Sense Self-Examination. Basically, it sort of amplifies the feeling of the lump in your breast if you put your hand in the glove. And his NGO distributes it through my foundation free of charge for women. And then, if you don't want that, because it's really just low-tech, we have a high-tech stuff that basically does exactly what it says, breast light. It basically allows a woman, having done the 12 o'clock, 3 o'clock, she now switches this on, the light comes on in a dark room, and she just goes around her breast. The way you cast light against a background, if it's something there, it will be dark. So it's a whole thing that that I really feel quite happy that women are given an additional tool to help them feel more confident about their breast health. It's all about being aware. And women can do their self breast examination every month, mm-hmm. just towards the end of their period when the breasts are not that tender or painful. Again, just to reassure women out there, if your breasts are painful during your periods, don't panic. Mm-hmm. It's purely normal. It's it's hormonal, and it will go away. And pain is the last thing we expect to find in women. Thank you.
And also, what other cancers should we be aware of? What are the, should we say more prominent cancers?
The common one again after breast is cervical cancer. The virus that causes cervical cancer is something that, I'm sorry to admit, we guys pass to women through sex. The virus stays on the skin of a man. And a man's genitalia is an extension of his skin. Pardon me being so graphic. However, once that gets into a woman, you know, if you cover that area with a sheath or a condom, the other parts of his body are still
in contact with
a woman. So close skin contact actually is enough to get the virus on the woman.
Wow.
And then the next time somebody comes along, again, protected, we'll simply push it in. So a woman having intercourse or outer course, as I've been told, at times you can describe it, playing around that area, rough play, can actually be at risk. And thankfully, we have got a vaccine against this virus. So if you're a young woman out there, between the age of 10, as a young girl, before you become sexually active, up to the age of 50, you can actually take this this vaccine. Women are beginning to take their responsibility. Say, look, I'm going to take care of my breast. Am I allowed to do that? I'm going to
take care of everything.
About grassroots women, though. That's why I'm really afraid, because they don't even know. Our culture is one where we don't talk.
They don't even know.
If a woman notices something, we'll hide it. And I won't tell anybody because of the stigma of being ill in our society, you know.
Quite a lot of women across the society, mix of society, really are responding very well, positively to cancer awareness. And the question they always ask is, when is the next one? When can we come out? And the grassroots women particularly, and we'll be quite happy to go to any location that a lot of women can be organized for us to do screening. So I'm very encouraged. Ever since we've been doing this and we've come back to Lagos, and some of the women will be calling us and saying, when are you coming to our own village? When are you coming to do this outreach? It's something we can put on the back of a truck and go to anywhere. And next month we'll be doing quite a lot outside Lagos as well. So people should just watch out for how we're doing this.
Wow. But you know, Dr. Lale, I was wondering, you know, you started out as a gynecologist. All of a sudden, why cancer? Like, where did your passion and interest for this particular, ailment?
Thank you very much. I'm still a gynecologist. I still practice gynae. It's just, a few things happened in my life, which you don't mind me sharing. My junior brother had blood cancer. Cancer can happen with blood too, as tiny as they look, the cells, called leukemia. He was 19 when he died. He was supposed to actually have gone to medical school that year. And one of the other things, again, is, well, you don't mind me going there.
Please go.
I'm a child of God who also believes that it's not fair that if there's a knowledge that's available,
people
perish for lack of knowledge.
You might be stealing from them.
So I'm very pleased that, well, through me, a lot of light has been shown in this area.
Lord.
So thank you for that question.
Shine the light.
Shine on. This is definitely a man who walks the talk.
Thank you very much.
We like men who walk the talk.
Exactly.
Thank you very much. Well done with this fantastic opportunity you've given us to raise awareness to a teeming audience of women out there.
Wow.
Thank you very much for coming on the show today, Dr. Olaleye. I'm sure our viewers watching will be considering, you know, getting cancer screening from now on, you know. So when we come back, we'll be doing something very fun and also very healthy, Zumba. You don't want to miss it. We'll be back.
We're having the time of our lives.
Hi, everyone. So as we learned earlier today, many illnesses in the world are caused by unhealthy living. So here with us, we have the amazing Trisha Maja, who is going to show us a few moves, give us a few tips on how to stay fit and healthy in a fun way. Because who are we kidding? Most of us, you know, personally, I'm not a gym person. So this is really something that you can do easily, even at home, on your own, with friends. And just, you know, keep fit and have fun. So tell us.
Well, Fusion Fitness, we're here, we're across Lagos. We have classes for everybody. It's for children, for men and women, both the same. It's for everybody. And it is, again, to promote that healthy lifestyle, to have it scheduled into your everyday life, that you take at least 30 minutes out of your day to just move. I mean, what we do is we're not rigid, we're not on the treadmill, we're moving. Yeah. We're moving to some great music. And, you know, we're just letting ourselves go. And it's a great stress relief. It's good for maintaining your body. And just, you know, that with a healthy, balanced diet, that's how we want to live. Really, I mean, I look at my father. My father-in-law is a Yoruba man, and he is almost 90 years old. He's still jumping on plane. I want to be like that.
Exactly.
I want to maintain my body. Exactly. I want to keep mobile. And the only way to do that is to always keep mobile.
It,
and he eats well, you know. So these are our examples. You know, I have four children. It's helped me to keep fit and well as well. So
yummy mommy on set.
I know I have a
yummy mommy on set.
So, you know, and my eldest is about to be 26. So, you know, it's helped me. But anyway, what I would, it would be lovely for you guys to come and join us. So why don't we...
I feel, oh my goodness, I just, okay.
But that's the truth, that's just me. So should we do some?
Yeah, yeah.
You guys? Are we ready to dance?
I think I'll give it a go. I'll see. This is my first time viewers, so bear with me. And yeah, so okay, let's do it.
Take it.
Okay. I can't see you guys.
I like the way you do the body. Make me want to be gummy body, be gummy body.
Okay.
Oh yeah, go go. So either if I look like square, I mean, do you really care? Cause for sure she keep you the really share. I see how you moving there. You better just stay in line. All I want to do is just make you mine. You make my heart beat like playing rap. Now you want to leave and say goodbye. I'm the girl, lady. You know, say you drive me crazy. I can't let you do. She just left my mind.
Wow. What a day. I absolutely enjoyed the Zumba exercises. I enjoyed watching, so well done. Well done, ladies. Thank you so much,
no
Trisha.
Problem. It's lovely, thank you.
Who said big girls can do?
Please. Oh my gosh, Choma. So as usual, we've had a very informative and fun time on Walk the Talk today, and I wanted to challenge you, especially ladies. You know, you heard all the statistics. You also heard that early screening is the key, you know, again, talking about cancer. So please, please, schedule an appointment with your doctor right away and go for a screening if you haven't. Cancer doesn't have to be a death sentence if detected early. So go for a screening, and even before, you know, you wait for all of that, Zumba. Easy fitness.
Absolutely.
It's fun. I saw it firsthand. So thank you for tuning in today. And remember, it's not over till it's over.
Tap. That's it. Just tap it out. Shake it out. We're going forward and back. Right leg. So forward. That's it.